Marketing is a powerful science with a goal to create demand and seed messages in our heads. The audio amplifier has around 20 parameters to be objectively evaluated regarding sound quality. As consumers, we're only aware of some of them, like RMS power, total harmonic distortions, frequency response and flatness. Those are important specifications, but not sufficient to make objective decision about audio amplifier quality. Let us remember what scientists discovered regarding the human hearing limits. It is scientifically proved in a distortion blind test results that the human hearing limit of total harmonic distortions is 0.1%. Now think, what is your emotional reaction of specs indicating that total harmonic distortions is below 0.1% across all audio spectrum? By default, it should mean that the amplifier is good. Is it working like that? Yes, you are right. It doesn't work for the audiophile and consumer market. The right messaging is that total harmonic distortions is 0.003% at 1 watt. Second, the hearing limit for a flat frequency is 0.25 decibel. This parameter is far more difficult than total harmonic distortion when we are talking about a complex speaker crossover cases, especially for three-way speakers. Tricky thing is that total harmonic distortions and the frequency gaps of audio amplifiers are measured to the resistive load. This is an easy test. Real speakers have crossovers. With complex impedance, an amplifier should deal with loads far worse than 4 ohms. Such parameters as a capability to drive 2 to 3 ohm load, damping factor, group delays, sleeve rate may be even more important than total harmonic distortions when driving 3 or 4-way speaker systems with complex crossover designs.